Hey, happy Saturday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, I'll give you the latest update on what's going on with this tropical. It's Tropical Depression 4 now. It will be Tropical Storm Debby, more likely later on this afternoon, and potentially going all the way up to Hurricane Debby right before it goes by the Big Bend of Florida. You can see they have a hurricane watch out now. This is all new information. You got your tropical storm watch, but you got a hurricane watch right here on the Big Bend. And you can see this is tropical storm force wind still going all the way from Tampa, all the way around to northern Florida, all the way to southern Georgia, even the coast of South Carolina now, and even the hurricane force wind gusts. That's what this is. Potentially could be on land as well. I'm still seeing a big strengthening right here. Matter of fact, this big circle you see right here, this is a great indicator of a stall. So I'm gonna show you all the latest information in this video. Everything has gone up a little bit, and remember, these two right here is from that potential next wave that's gonna be forming up after. That's not gonna be in this video, that will be in tomorrow's video. It won't be an update this afternoon because it is Sabbath, and this storm is literally still gonna be right here in the Gulf, still going north, so it's still gonna be a day or so before it gets even further to north. But there is threats for tornadoes for today, also for tomorrow, and as it goes up the coast. Now, if you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long with my weather forecasting. Make sure you click that bell, select all, so you do get the updates. I do updates in the afternoon, just not today. This is Sabbath, the seventh day. You're always supposed to rest. Unless lives are at risk, you're supposed to do what you can to save them, but still get your rest. Now, the latest information on the wind field shows as it pulls by Tampa and Sarasota that you could still get some of the winds in a wind gust, showing 58 miles per hour sustained winds, up to 69 miles per hour wind gust. Then as it goes further up towards northern Florida, this is where it gets towards hurricane force. It gets 69 miles per hour sustained winds. This is where the warmest waters are also where it's going to do some rapid intensification right before landfall. Now, I am seeing there's a little bit of shear getting on the western side of this storm as it heads to the north and putting a little bit of dry air and pushing it a little bit off-centered where it's not vertically stacked. Still, if it gets strong enough before that fact, it could fight that off. But showing for northern Florida, anywhere from 69 miles per hour sustained winds, 86 miles per hour wind gusts. Showing it will weaken down as it goes by northern Florida into Georgia with 52 miles per hour sustained winds and 63 miles per hour wind gusts, and go down to 40 miles per hour sustained winds, 52 miles per hour sustained gusts. But you can see it does start to pick back up from 52, starts jumping up to 63, 75 miles per hour wind gusts, and getting stronger. It just sits here and builds and either goes off towards the northeast. You can see some of the ensembles showing that, going all the way towards the northeast, or it could go inland, or both. Now, you can also see, and remember, this time and date up here is Central Time, that as it moves further for today, as you go into this afternoon, you're going to start getting those bandings coming right across southern Florida, also for the Florida Keys, all evening long, all the way to later tonight, and then it's going to pass by you while it's going overnight. Now, this is bringing y'all chances for tornadoes for today. And remember, when it comes with these storms, they're usually quick spin-ups, but you can't rule out something lasting a little bit longer. You saw what happened with Beryl, but Beryl had the winds going in its favor. And you see this will be a little bit closer for tomorrow as it starts growing a little bit into a storm, trying to become a hurricane as it goes by Sarasota and Tampa. You can see all those bandings bringing you chances for tornadoes also. And it will stretch all the way out towards Orlando by the time you go towards tomorrow night. Then as it gets closer towards landfall, look how it tightens up. With all this banding, this is bringing chances for strong winds and bringing chances to be whipping up some tornadoes that comes in that system. Now, so far showing it could possibly be early in the morning landfall. Not showing that that is going to be fact just yet. That's just what I'm seeing in the model run as of today. And taking it a little bit further to the west. Now, it is moving west-northwest at 16 miles per hour still. You have tropical storm watch in this yellow for the Florida Keys. That's because it's still going to be a depression strengthening up as it passes by you, but you still got chances for tornadoes for today. Tropical storm warning in a blue. Tropical storm watch over here in the Florida Panhandle. That could ramp up as well. And you got the hurricane watch in the pink. Storm surge has changed also. You still got chances from 1 to 3 feet in all these blue sections, even 1 to 2 feet. But over here from the Charlotte Harbor, you got chances for 2 to 4 feet all the way up. Then once you get by the Big Bend area, it goes from 3 to 5 feet. Then it's 1 to 3 feet once again. This is going to ramp up again as this storm strengthens and intensifies. Remember, all the onshore flooding is going to be spinning around into this direction as it goes further north. This is also bringing you those tornado threats as well. So you have 1 to 2 inches in the light green. This is going all the way up towards the northeast so far also. 2 to 4 inches in the all this dark green. You see how it has changed some. Now you get to 4 to 6 inches in all this lighter yellow color. But the darker yellow color, this is all 6 to 8 inches all the way. And see how it's going more inland on South Carolina. But now you got 8 to 12. Well, you got some over here for Florida still. There's little pockets of it. But look over here for Georgia and South Carolina and North Carolina. That's 8 to 12 inches expected. This is within a 5-day period. It's going to sit there and stall even longer. And I think you're going to get that 12 inches plus on land. And this will put a lot of y'all in a flash flood status. You will be in a slight risk all the way from Florida, going all the way up towards Delaware, Maryland, Virginia, way up towards the northeast. This is going to be later on. But you see that moderate section all the way from Jacksonville, Florida, Georgia, and South Carolina. That's because of that stall. Now for today, you do have chances for tornadoes in all this green section. So far, here's your cities at risk for that. For tomorrow, this is going to grow also from central to northern Florida, go into Georgia. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the tornado threat for tomorrow, for Sunday. And I expect this to keep on going right up the coast. We also are getting a little bit of an agreement of where this storm system is going to be. You can see literally in 24 hours, they are in agreement is going to be right offshore. Still taking that wide turn. And you can see in 48 hours, it could be bending in towards the Big Bend of Florida, or go a little bit northern. The hurricane models is showing a little bit northern. And all this makes a big difference with what happens down the road. But still, you can see down the road, look at this big cluster of 72 hours. That's going to be a big stall and potentially a strengthening hurricane. When you look at other models, you can see with the Canadian is seeing that going right north, just like them hurricane models are showing. And you see how it goes around also to the northeast. You go by the Ural is taking a little bit in towards the Big Bend area. And when you go by the GFS, it's agreeing with the Ural, the Big Bend area. So there's two different regions. Now, one thing that's been true so far about tracking this storm, the Ural has been correct about path. GFS has been correct about strength. And when you look at the latest ensembles, you can see literally in 24 hours, there they are grouping up as you go towards 48 hours, agreeing that it will be right here towards northern Florida by the Big Bend. But look how it goes straight north a little bit more rather than curving. You see that? It goes straight north. Then it curves a little bit later. See how that curves a little bit later? That would agree with the hurricane models, not the GFS and the Ural. I will show you the hurricane models in a second. As you go towards 3 days, it starts spreading out a little bit where it's going to be, potentially on land doing a stall. And as you go all the way to 4 days, still sitting in that region. And as you go all the way towards 5 days, look how it consolidates right towards the Carolinas. But now it's starting to get a little bit more spread out. And this is when we still got a next wave that we got to worry about what's going to happen after that. And I do believe it will still have some intensification going on. You can see the warmest waters is going to be right in its path. And it's going to intensify as it goes towards landfall. So as we take a look with the hurricane models, you can see with the H-Wharf as it swings by, it starts intensifying as it heads a little bit more to the west in the panhandle of Florida. And look how it just stays on land and just does that little stall for a little bit. That's going to be a long duration event. I think it's going to be a lot of heavy rainfall, especially for the Carolinas. And you can also see this same banding that I showed you in the beginning of the video. You're going to get the chances for the tornadoes as that gets closer and closer, and the more it intensifies, the more the eastern and northern side of this cyclone is where your threat is really going to be for these chances for these tornadoes. But this banding that's bringing around, these outer bands also bring chances for tornadoes, and usually they're quick spin-ups. But showing when it goes on land, it will still be there twirling around, dropping a lot of heavy rainfall and maybe come right back out on the coast and strengthen back up again. And you can see the amount of rainfall just for the next 5 days showing by the H-Wharf. All this going right up from southern Florida and northern. This is anywhere from 3 to 5 inches. But once you go all the way from the panhandle into Georgia and South Carolina, all that brown is going anywhere from 7 to 8 inches. And once you get to that white, to that purple, you start going from 10 inches plus. Now, to try and follow a trend, you can see with Hurricane Analysis Forecast System A, showing it will start intensifying right before landfall and a little bit to the west as well. And look how it sits there on land and it does that stall effect. That stall is going to be a big problem. Remember my forecast days ago, if it don't make it out by Monday, it will not be able to make it out. And the rainfall rates according to that model. A little bit heavier for southern Florida, spread out a little bit further to the east. Remember, the banding is going to go over Florida and be swinging around into the Atlantic. So it is going to be some big banding. Don't worry about the eye. You know it's the big banding that's going to be the main problem. And you can see all the heavy rainfall. 7 to 8 inches in all this brown, 10 inches plus in all of this white. And to try and find that trend, you can see with Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B, intensifying before landfall a little bit further to the west and showing that stall effect. That's trending. And showing the same thing, a lot of heavy rainfall, mostly for northern Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, and this one brings it into North Carolina. Now you can see with the euro, remember the strength is not correct with the euro, but the path has been correct. Euro and GFS is agreeing with that turning right towards the Big Bend area. Look how it goes offshore and just blows up. Just strengthens up right offshore, gets you down to a hurricane. Then it goes on land. Now you get all the winds, you get all the rains. This is building up. Then it gets pushed out by the next trough, and it goes out through the northeast as a strong system. Look at that. A little bit closer. This keeps getting closer, a little bit closer, and y'all going to have a big problem in the northeast as well from this system way over here by Cuba. Now, as we blow this up on the big picture with the euro, you can see as it starts moving northern, it starts getting a little bit of shear. And you can see the shear because it's moving this dry air on the western side of the system. So what you have is you have a very disorganized system. You have dry air on the western side. All your moisture and precipitation is getting pushed to the eastern side. And you can see all that pushing over. So it is getting sheared. So it's not staying really strong vertically stacked. So it might take it a little bit for it to finally get its strength up. But look how it gets closer towards landfall. Starts showing that gets a little more consolidated. Your isobars get a little more tight, wound, and it starts getting a little bit better organized, but still showing you got somewhat a shear and some dry air on the western side. This is only according to the euro. A lot of other models show there's a little bit, but it's not going to be so much where it's going to impend it from strengthening before landfall. Still, euro shows it's going to sit there the whole time and get dry air on the western side. Then maybe start strengthening up. You see the isobars start strengthening up once it gets away from that shear and that dry air right off the coast of Georgia and the Carolinas. This is not good. But showing that the rainfall is going to add up. Here you are going towards 5 days. See how it's starting to add up with all that purple gets towards 10 inches and a foot and more. But with the stall effect, this is where it starts adding up to a worrisome amount. Look at all that heavy rainfall and how far inland all that goes. And it goes all the way up the coast. We're talking about possible 7 to 8 inches up to 10 inches all the way towards Maryland. This is going to be a very strong system. Try and go by a trend with those models. You can see with GFS, it does strengthen up right before landfall. Remember, GFS was correct on the strength. And then look how it goes right offshore. Strengthens up again, which GFS showed days ago. So that is a trend. Also coming on land, bringing you all the heavy rainfall and the winds. Staying strong all the way on land. You see that? It's not weakening down. It's staying a strong system all the way to the northeast. You see that? But look at the rainfall amounts. Showing the same thing. This more likely could push onshore for South Carolina. Maybe a couple feet of water. Be aware, this is going far inland on South Carolina. Not to mention the other states getting all this heavy rainfall. This right here would be catastrophic, and it is starting to trend South Carolina. You need to start thinking about getting preparations for flooding. Be careful. Get your supplies because this is starting to trend your way. Y'all might get the worst case out of this whole storm. Waited for the update on the GFS, the 6Z, showing the same thing. Then you get that stall, the strengthening. Also starting to see it come back, everybody. So look at the ensembles. You can see literally here we are right past 48 hours. A lot of them are in agreement where this is going to landfall at. This being your control member, your more likely outcome does have it by the Big Bend area. But if you watch it, after it goes across Georgia and Florida, some of these show that as it starts strengthening up, as we go towards 5 days now, starting to make a comeback towards the west already and starts coming back into the Gulf. Not everyone is showing it, but it is showing it in a few model runs. Now, this could easily be the next wave manipulating this a little bit, so I will keep you updated. It's just a little concerning. Thank you for your time, everybody. Thank you to everybody that hits that share button down below. Just simply hit that like button down below. Help other people know this information. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And I truly hope y'all have a very blessed day today. Please finish any preparations that you need to finish. Because once it starts going onshore, you really can't go nowhere until it's over. But I do appreciate every single one of y'all. Now, there won't be an afternoon update, of course. Not only is it Sabbath, but there is lives at risk. That's why I did put out a video this morning. But this is going to take them some time as it goes across the Gulf. But it is bringing that tornado threat for this morning. So I appreciate everybody. I will see you first thing in the morning. And all of our updates will start again for tomorrow. Now, before I go today, a quick reminder for you. Luke 6, verse 9. Then said Jesus unto them, I will ask you one thing. Is it lawful on the Sabbath days to do good or to do evil? To save life or to destroy it? Amen. Have a great day, everybody. My heart goes out to every single one of y'all, and I will see you first thing in the morning. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I truly hope that he puts a lot of dry air and cheer in the system. Keeps it just a weak tropical storm. I know y'all can handle that. Florida's very tough people. A lot of people in Florida says that they can handle it all the way up to a major hurricane. They don't care. They're very strong people. I truly hope God weakens this storm with that dry air and that shear and just keeps it a rain event. I do hope he does fix it, though, for the Carolinas because this is looking like a bad scenario for y'all. All the updates just keeps trending this very strong winds and this very, very bad flooding for y'all. So please stay up to date on the updates. I wish the best for every single one of y'all today and forever in Jesus Christ's name of Nazareth. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen, Jesus. Have a great day, everybody. Do what you can to prepare. Make sure you check on your neighbors. Make sure they're in the right state of mind for this storm.